In this tutorial, I will show you how to add Bootstrap CSS into your custom Magento 2 theme. And at the end of the video, I'm going to give you a small surprise, which I encourage you to watch and follow going forward. Let's roll the intro. This is not an exception that Bootstrap helps you to build your custom theme, and especially with Magento 2, when there is some knowledge gap between existing CSS or less styles, and the fact that Bootstrap is probably the number one library which is used among all web and front-end developers, and it's quicker to build something with Bootstrap rather than with out-of-box Luma theme or blank Magento themes. So in this video, I would like to show you how we can get started with Bootstrap and Magento 2. First, I would go into a documentation section and will find a package which is available for me for download. So I have two options: compile CSS and JS or source files. I will go ahead and download a source so I can include these files into my source code. Once you will unarchive this package, you will see a Bootstrap latest version, and at the moment of recording this video, this is a 4.3.1 version, and under dist you would find CSS files as well as JS. I'm going to copy bootstrap.css into my Magento 2 theme and make it available on my front-end pages. What I've did, I created a CMS page with some CSS styles from Bootstrap. So once I will have a Bootstrap loaded on a page, this all markup would make more sense than without. So for instance, we have Jumbotron. This is a CSS style from Bootstrap, as well as navbar. So as we can see that there are some styles. And once bootstrap.css will be loaded, this all styles or markup would make more sense for this content. There are a few things I did for this video. First of all, I've created an empty theme under app design frontend, and my theme name is Pronko Consulting, and two files, registration.php and theme.xml, which provides required information for declaring a front-end theme. This is the first thing. And second, I did switch a theme to Pronko Consulting theme so I can make necessary changes in my theme directory and make Bootstrap available on our front-end pages. So let's start our work. I have to create a directory called web/CSS inside my theme, and I'm going to copy this file into this CSS directory. So once it's available under my theme, I have to say to Magento that this file has to be loaded. And for this, I will create a layout file, a layout XML file, and this file has to be located under Magento theme /layout directory. And name of this XML file should be default head blocks.xml. In this file, I will place an XML with a root node page, and inside I have head. So it means that everything which is declared inside head node is going to be loaded into HTML head tag. Here I'm going to use CSS node name with the src attribute, and inside I have to provide path to my bootstrap.css file. And path to my bootstrap.css file should be relevant to web directory inside my theme. So this is going to be Pronko Consulting web, and starting from web, we have to provide this relative path. So CSS and bootstrap.css. In order to tell Magento platform that we have a new file, new XML file, we have to go to console and run bin Magento cache clean command. So in this way, we will clean cache, including layout cache. As you can see, we have layout cache. We could also run bin magenta cache clean layout, and it will clean only layout related cache. And on the front end, we have to go and refresh our home page. So this is how we can add Bootstrap CSS to our custom front end theme. And as you can see, all styles were applied from Bootstrap CSS file into our markup, which I've added to a home page. So this is a case where we have a CSS file in our theme, and we can include this CSS file to be loaded on a page. However, if we would like to go and use CDN version of Bootstrap, let's find, here an URL and copy this URL. Also, we can change a declaration and include external CSS file by providing CSS src and one more required argument with the Magento layouts has to be src type. And in our case, it's URL. Let's go and clean cache. And if we will open view page source, we could find Bootstrap loaded from Bootstrap CDN. This is how we can add bootstrap.css file into our custom theme. As a homework, I would like to propose you to add a JavaScript file into custom theme and load it on a homepage. Thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you liked it. Hit subscribe and like button, and I will see you in my next tutorial. Bye.